Fine, teacher. And you?
Nice. Everything is nice here. How was your weekend?
Oh, very
stressful. No, yeah. Really? Why? A lot of homeworks.
Yeah, homework.
Sorry.
Yeah.
But this is your last year, right?
No. No. Oh no, the next year.
The next one. Okay.
Yeah.
Hello, Karina. Hi, Melania. Hello, Yasmin.
Hello, teacher. Good night.
Hello, good evening. How are you, Yasmin?
Okay.
Nice. Karina, is your audio okay? Melanie? Melanie, excuse me.
Hola, teacher.
Hi.
Hi, teacher.
Ay, perdón. Hello, hello. Yo me estoy comiendo unas pasas. Hello, Marcelo. Welcome. Hi, Genesis.
Hello.
Okay, students. Give to me 30 seconds. 30 segundos y vamos a iniciar. Vamos a iniciar en este caso con las preguntas. Teacher, ¿y por qué no las mandó ayer? Uno, porque es domingo. Dos, porque yo no quiero que esto sea memorizado. O sea, cuando nosotros tenemos y discutimos preguntas en inglés como estas que les mandé ahora, es para que practiquemos inglés. El inglés no es para que usted memorice las cosas, es para que fluidamente usted comience a hablar. Algunos de ustedes ya manejan un nivel bastante, bastante bien, básico, y les ayuda un montón, pero no es memorizar, por eso es que no se las mando un día antes, porque yo sé que todos van a comenzar a hacer la tarea, y no es tarea, es solamente para practicar. Ok, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. In this case, we have 4 questions. Question number 1 is, what are you going to do on vacation? Les voy a dar unos ejemplos de cómo más o menos usted puede contestar, porque como les repito, yo aquí tengo gente de diferentes niveles. Hay algunos que no les cuesta, hay algunos que les cuesta un poco. Ahora bien, ¿qué vas a hacer en vacaciones? Example number 1. My plans for vacations are go to the beach, go tan, next to the swimming pool, and rest. De todo el vocabulario que tengo acá, yo sé que tal vez algunos no se pueden esta palabra, tan. ¿Qué significa tan? Cuando yo digo go tan. Ajá, estudiantes. ¿Qué cree que significa esa palabra? Tan.
Algo así como, no sé, ¿verdad? Pero algo así como desde.
Bronceado.
Broncearse. Excelente. Broncearse. Ah, okay. Muy bien. No se preocupe que para eso estamos aquí. Eso me encanta. O sea, equivoquémonos y así nos vamos a ir aprendiendo. En ese caso, tan es un verbo. Significa broncearse. Got tan next to the swimming pool and rest. Y descansar. Another option is, my plans for vacations are stay at home and watch TV. Simple. Ahora bien, en este caso, esos son ejemplos míos. Usted puede adaptarlos a los suyos. Usted puede comenzar en ese caso. Ok, yo le hago la pregunta. What are you going to do on vacation? Well, teacher, my plans for vacations are. Mis planes para vacaciones son. O singular. My plan for vacation is. Mi plan para vacación es. Y en este caso, yo les quise hacer acá como dos ejemplos de más o menos. Aunque obviamente hay un montón de verbos que podemos ocupar. Teacher, my plans for vacations. Permítame, voy a ingresar a alguien. My plans for vacation are, well, get up late. Levantarme tarde, teacher. Get up late. Don't do homeworks. No hacer tareas, teacher. Don't do homeworks. Maybe hanging out or go out to the park or go out to the cinema, go out to the mall, go out for a cafe, etc. Okay. Volunteers. I need one volunteer. 5, 4.
Me.
Okay, thank you, Christian. Okay, the simple question is, Christian, what are you going to do on vacation?
My plans for my vacation are sleep, watch movies, and climb volcanoes.
Excellent. So, can you repeat it, number one?
The question or the answer?
The answer, please.
Okay. My plans for my vacation are sleep.
Sleep, uh-huh.
Watch movies. And climb volcanoes.
And climb volcanoes. So in this case, how many hours do you consider are you going to sleep on vacation?
I don't know, maybe
more than 8?
12 hours.
No, that's nice. That's not so well. In my case, I cannot sleep more than 9 or 8 hours. The recommendation is 8, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, do you have any idea to, for example, you say you are going to stay at home, right? And maybe climb the volcanoes. Yes?
Sorry?
So, you say, I would like to stay at home and sleep. Yeah. But there is a possibility that to go to climb volcanoes.
Yes. Because I go to climb volcanoes in a day.
It is difficult to climb it?
Sometimes.
Or it depends of the person?
The volcano.
And the okay. In your personal experience, which volcano have you climbed before?
In my opinion, climb the Izalco volcanoes is so hard.
Really? How many hours do you take to climb it? How many hours?
Maybe 10.
What? It's true.
Yeah.
10 hours.
Yeah, for the way is a
the role is a difficult role.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay. Wow. Well, thank you so much, Christian. Can you please help me to choose the next student?
Yeah. Karina.
Okay, Karina, are you ready?
Yes, teacher, I'm ready.
Okay, Christian, please ask the question to Karina.
Yes. What are you going to do on vacation?
Well, my plan for my vacation is go to the Quetzaltenango in the Guatemala City.
Hey, can we travel to Guatemala now? It is available, the frontier.
What?
It is available, the frontier of Guatemala.
¿Qué es available?
Está habilitada, habilitada, available.
Yeah.
But do you need to take the COVID test?
Test? Yeah.
Oh my God. my goodness, how much is it? $50, $100?
No. 65 for...
Per person.
Yeah.
$65. So, but it is true that are you going to go to Guatemala or not?
It's true.
It's true. Well, I remember... Yes,
my stepfather... His family lives in Guatemala.
Oh, that's nice. Which part, excuse me? Which city?
Quetzaltenango.
Quetzaltenango. Can you please describe it? Have you there before? ¿Ya has estado ahí?
Yeah. Cada año.
Oh, really? Can you please describe the place?
Okay. The place is similar to Mexico.
Well, in my case, I never have been in Mexico. It's like a
panito. No, lo digo porque está cerca, o sea, es como ya un paso a México.
Oh, uh-huh. Okay, please continue.
Yeah. It's clean, very clean.
Oh my goodness. Well, mm-hmm.
That persons that lives here, the persons,
uh-huh. The people.
Yeah, the people are indigenous.
Indians. Ah, okay, yeah. Interesting. So, is there a traditional dishes? Is there a traditional, for example, like pupusas in El Salvador?
No.
Is there a famous food there?
The famous food is tacos and hay un platillo de pollo que no recuerdo cómo es que se llama.
There is a chicken dish. Okay, yes, okay. That's okay, that's it. Thank you, Kari. Can you please choose the next student?
No sé quiénes están.
Oh my goodness, we have 11 students.
Okay, Jonathan.
Okay, thank you. Stay there, please, Karina. Jonathan, are you ready?
Yes.
Excellent. I'm okay, here. Perfect. Karina, please ask the question to Jonathan.
What are you going to do on vacation?
My plans for vacation are travel to Japan because I want to buy a
continue.
Because I want to buy something that I like to have it as a souvenir.
Excuse me, Jonathan. What kind of souvenir is it? What kind of souvenir is it? ¿Qué tipo de obsequio, de recuerdo es?
No sé cómo sería esto. Sería como una...
It's like a...
Como una figura. ¿Cómo se dice eso?
It's like a figure.
A figure.
It's an animal.
¿Cómo?
Is it an animal?
Anima.
Yeah, the figure. The figure is literally
animal.
Hey, ¿estás distraído, hijo?
Sí. So,
okay, no te preocupes. Okay, but this is a personal question. It is true or it is false that would you like to go to Japan? Or are you going to travel to Japan?
No, it's fake.
Okay, excellent. Okay, no, that's nice. Well, in my case, I consider Japan is one of the most amazing city. I like Tokyo. It's my favorite city.
Yeah, my favorite city in Japan is Akihabara because I don't know, it is very, very strange. No sé cómo explicar eso.
No, don't worry about. Well, I mentioned because I was in Tokyo in 2007. I was visiting the first city that I was visiting was Yokohama. This is a very normal town. It's like a paneca. It's not like a paneca, but it's something like this. And the second was Tokyo. Wow, Tokyo is really amazing. The technology, the culture, the food, the people, the buildings, the road, totally amazing. Oh, I don't know how to explain, but I respect the Japanese people. The first one is because the culture. Because I was there in summer, and you see the women wearing mini skirts, mini dresses, and the men respect them. So, wow, the culture is totally amazing. And my story is true, Jonathan, it isn't false. Oh. Yes, my story is true. I had the opportunity to go there, and my goodness, if you want, you can check it on my Facebook. Wow, there is a beautiful city. Every single weekend, you are going to have, you're going to see paradise. Do you know what does it mean, paradise? Es como los, somos como los desfiles del 15 de septiembre en El Salvador. But in Japan, there is a paradise every single weekend. Can you believe it? So this is a very amazing city. So another plans that you have for vacation, Jonathan?
I don't know. I think that I stay at home.
With your family?
With my family, or maybe I am going to the beach.
Okay, nice.
Yeah. ¿Cómo se llama este lugar?
Which one?
Atami? Atami?
Ah, okay. Yeah. Yesterday I was visiting San Blas. Have you ever visited San Blas, the beach?
No.
No? It is nice. Okay. And I like Atami too. I like it. Thank you so much, Jonathan. Thank you. Yeah. Can you please help me to choose the next student?
I pick Marcelo.
Okay, Marcelo, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Jonathan, please ask the same question to Marcelo.
What are you going to do on vacation?
I don't know, but it's hard to get out and to stay house, maybe.
And watching Netflix or listening to music?
Play video games.
Ah, okay. Well, in my case, Marcelo, I don't like to play in video games. I prefer watch, well, I don't like to watch television either, but I prefer to watch Netflix or listen to music, go to the park, something like that. Very simple. So in your case, you said you are going to stay at home. Yes or no?
What?
In your case, yes. You said you are going to stay at home. Okay. And you are going to play video games, right?
Yes.
Okay. How many hours do you play video games, Marcelo? A day?
I don't know. 2 hours, 3 hours.
2 hours per day. So what's your favorite video game?
I don't know. No, nothing.
You don't have favorite?
No.
Repeat. I don't have favorite.
I don't have favorite.
Okay, you don't have favorite video game. Okay, the next question is, do you like to watch television or prefer to watch Netflix?
Netflix. Is better.
Netflix, yes, it is totally. I totally agree with you.
Yes.
Yes.
¿Cómo se dice? Si hay.
There is.
O sea, si. ¿Cómo?
Por ejemplo, si hay una película.
Ajá.
If there is a movie, si hay una película, if there is a movie.
Is there a match?
Uh-huh. What is match? What is match?
Match partido.
Ah, the games. Partido. Okay, yes, I got it. Well, so in my case, I just like to. Okay, permítame, voy a apagarle acá el micrófono a alguien que se escucha un pequeño ruidito ahí. Ahí estoy. Well. In my case, this is true, Marcelo, esto es verdad. This is true, totally true. I love to watch Netflix, but I prefer to watch series than movies. And you? What about you? What do you prefer, to watch series or to watch movies?
Series. And I see now Anatomy, no, Grey's Anatomy.
Mira, hay cuánta gente me menciona esa serie, yo creo que la voy a comenzar a ver. Okay, can you
please,
is nice?
Por eso yes. Me voy a hacer, yes, por eso me voy a hacer cirujano.
Okay, well, would you like to be a surgeon? Surgeon, cirujano. Yes or no?
Si quiero ser.
Ajá, would you like
no,
to be?
No, no, no.
Well, the last question. Disgusting.
Disgusting.
Es como que me disgusta. Ay, disgusting. Ok, excelente. Iba a hacer otra pregunta, pero muy bien. Thank you, Marcelo. Please, choose the next student.
No, siga, siga, siga.
No, for the time. I have, no, tengo más dinámicas. Okay, okay, ok, Marcelo. Choose the next one. A boy or a girl?
A girl.
A girl. Ok, choose one, please.
Kayla.
Keila, ok, thank you. Con Keila termino la pregunta número uno y me paso a la dos. Ok, Keila, good evening.
Good, thank you, teacher. Sorry for
okay. No, no,
la
no.
Tardanza.
No, don't worry. To be late, no, don't worry. Ok, Marcelo, can you please read the question number one for Keila?
What are you going to do on vacation?
My plans for this vacation are sleep the first day, and then probably I go to the beach or go to the, I don't know.
Well, in my personal opinion, Kayla, sorry for interrupting you. Mm-hmm. I prefer to go to the beach before vacation.
Oh, yes.
Because, yes, before, for me it's better. Because if you go to the beach at the same time with the vacation is at the app.
The most people.
The traffic. Yes, most people, and the traffic jam is horrible.
Yes.
So I recommend to you, if you want to go to the beach, please go back before vacation.
Yes.
Okay, so you said you are going to sleep, yes. Right? How many hours?
All days. maybe 12 hours. Daily. Uh-huh.
Okay, excellent. And at what time do you go to bed? At what time do you go to bed?
Usually at 10 p.m.
p.m. Okay. Okay. And the last question. What is the last thing? ¿Cuál es la última cosa? What is the last thing you do before go to bed?
I read the Bible and pray.
Ah, you're right. Okay, excellent. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, vamos con la siguiente pregunta. Thank you, Kayla. Okay, next question. What do you prefer? Algunos ya me respondieron esta. What do you prefer? To stay at home or hanging out with your family? Para comenzar, ¿qué significa? Porque sé que algunos quizás no lo saben. ¿Qué significa hanging out? ¿Me quedé sin alumnos? ¿Qué cree usted que significa hanging out? Cuando dice hanging out with your family.
¿Qué haces afuera? ¿Cómo te diviertes?
Salir a pasear, algo así.
Ok, muy bien, señorita, pues ambas tienen más o menos la razón. Hanging out es simple y sencillamente pasar el tiempo con tu familia, con tus amigos, etcétera. So, pasar el tiempo es una expresión bien informal. Hanging out, si yo lo traduzco literalmente, es como que sostener afuera, pero aquí no. Es hanging out, es pasar el tiempo. Entonces, ¿qué prefieren ustedes? ¿Stay at home? Or hanging out with your family. Comienzo con voluntarios y tengo 5, 4, 3.
Yo, Jeremy.
2. Ok, excelente, Jeremy. Thank you. Please, your opinion.
Okay. ¿Ya respondo?
Yes, please.
Okay, I prefer to stay at home because I like to play video games or listen to music while I play video games.
Ah, okay, that is nice. So, in this case, how often do you hanging out? O sea, ya sé que dice quedarte en casa, pero en este caso, the opposite. How often, okay. ¿Qué tan a menudo? How often do you hanging out with your family? Just on weekends, just for vacation.
I think normally.
Okay, normally, yes, me too. In my case, well, no, in my case, I always hanging out with my family just, I don't know why, but it is true, but just on Saturdays afternoon. Because my family and me, we love coffee. So I like to go out and have a cup of coffee. So in this, thank you, Jeremy. Thank you so much. So in this case, I have these options. Quiero que observe acá. Para contestar esta pregunta, así como lo hizo Jeremy, está más que excelente. Aquí tengo otras opciones. Usted puede decir, in my opinion, I prefer to stay at home, or in my opinion, I prefer to hanging out. Otra opción para contestar puede ser, well, I consider it's better to stay at home, or, well, bueno, I consider it's better to hanging out because, y me tiene que dar una razón, porque, etc. Otro ejercicio, otro ejemplo puede ser, well, teacher, I prefer to stay at home because it has many advantages. ¿Qué significa, estudiantes, esa palabra advantages? What is advantages? Cuando yo digo, it has many advantages.
Ventajas.
Excelente. Muchas gracias, señorita. Tiene muchas ventajas quedarme en casa. I prefer to stay at home because it has many advantages. Number one, blah, blah, blah. Advantage number two, blah, 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 etc., etc., etc. Ok. Volunteer. What do you prefer? Stay at home or hang? Well, in this case, Jonathan, please help me to choose the next student. Thank you.
Perdón, hijo.
Marcela no había leído tu mensaje, hija. Ok, perdón, no había escuchado, no había leído tu mensaje. ¿Todo bien, Marce?
Yes, teacher.
Vaya, hija, excelente. Perdón, no había leído tu mensaje. Perdón, este, Jonathan.
Don't worry.
Ok, thank you. Choose one student, please.
I pick Melanie, William.
Ok, excellent, thank you. Ok, Camila Wider, are you ready?
Yes.
Ok, please, princess, give us your opinion. What do you prefer, Camille? Stay at home or hanging out with your family?
I prefer to go out with my family to eat or for a work.
Okay, excellent. Well, in this case, you prefer to hanging out with your family. How often do you hanging out with them?
¿Cómo, teacher?
How often do you hanging out with your family?
La ventaja de...
¿Qué tan a menudo sales con tu familia? How often do you hanging out? Sometimes, on weekends, on Fridays, on Saturdays.
Sometimes.
Sometimes. So in this case, well, in my case, I always hanging out with my family on Sundays. And we like, nos gusta, we like to go to Pizza Hut, for example. Mm-hmm. And you, and your family? Puedes decir, mi familia y yo, my family and me like to, nos gusta.
My family and...
And me.
And me, I like.
Like to, ajá. Como ya tenés el me, Ah, okay, excellent. Chinese food.
Yes.
Okay, ahora decímelo todo en inglés. A mi familia y mí, a mi familia y mí. A mi familia y a mí nos gusta ir a comer comida china. Vaya.
My family and me
like
to go. Se me olvidó cómo dijo comida china, teacher.
Chinese food.
Chinese food.
Vaya, en este caso podemos, mira, aquí puedes decirlo de dos maneras. My family and me like to go to Chinese restaurants. Nos gusta ir a los restaurantes chinos. Uh-huh. Y se entiende que es para comer comida china. China. O puedes decir, my family and me like to go and eat Chinese food. Y comer comida china.
Ok.
Okay? Yes. Excellent. Thank you. Cami, please choose the next student. I'm going to help you. I have Daniela, Genesis. I have, oh my, Andrea and Jasmine.
Andrea.
Thank you so much. Hello, Andrea. Good evening. Welcome.
Hello.
Ready?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. Camila, please read question number two to Andrea.
What do you prefer, to stay at home or hanging out with your family?
I prefer to stay at home because I feel quiet in my house. I can rest, and my mom likes cook.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
So what kind of food does your mother cook? Salvadorian or the typical Salvadorian food? What kind of food?
Salvadorian food.
Okay.
For example, chicken. Fried.
Mm-hmm.
And crema también.
And cream.
So, chicken and cream.
Ah, okay, perfect, nice. So, talking about you, Andrea, can you cook? Do you have the ability to cook?
I don't like cook.
You don't like to cook?
I can't cook.
Ah, excellent. So, in your house, who is the person in charge? ¿Quién es la persona a cargo? Who is the person in charge that cook in the house?
My sister.
Ah, okay. Your sister. Yeah. What's your sister's name? Her name is?
Alejandra.
Her name is Alejandra. So, your sister, yes, she cooks. So, in your case, what ability... Your personal, you, talking about you, Andrea. What abilities do you have? For example, in my case, one of my abilities is I can sing. Es mentira, pero aquí se trata de inventar. I can sing. What is your ability, Andrea?
Yes, I can sing. I can.
It's true or false?
I can dance.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Sing and dance. Can you swim?
No, I can't.
No, I can't. Okay, can you speak Japanese?
No, I can't.
Can you speak English? A little bit?
In this moment,
yes.
Yes.
Okay, nice, Andrea, thank you. Okay, thank stay you. There. Quedémonos ahí, Andrea, para la pregunta número 3. What happened with the... Ah, yes. Describe yourself, please, Andrea. Choose. I'm going to help you. Te voy a ayudar. I have Daniela, Genesis. I have... And Jasmine. Daniela, Genesis, and Jasmine. Please.
Genesis,
thank you. Good evening, Genesis.
Hi.
Hello, Princess. Are you ready?
Yes.
Perfect. Andrea, Well, in this case, no, thank you, Andrea, thank you, thank you. Well, in this case, it is an equation, just describe yourself. Si ustedes se fijan, hay algunas palabras que yo sí las puse en español. Teacher, ¿y por qué esas están en español y las demás no? Porque las que he puesto en español son las palabras que normalmente, por no decir siempre, los alumnos no se pueden en este caso. Entonces, antes de que Génesis se describa a ella misma cómo es su personalidad, le voy a pedir de favor a Karina, ¿me ayudas a leer el vocabulario, por favor? Y
yes,
ojo con los audífonos, perdón, con los audios. Thank you, Karina.
Calm.
¿Qué significa calm? Una persona
tranquila.
Calmada.
Calmada o tranquila. Next.
Friendly.
Uh-huh.
Amigable.
Una persona amigable. Next.
Easy going.
Uh-huh. Una persona.
Fácil de tratar, no.
Fácil de tratar o de llevar. O sea, es una persona que donde quiera que llegue, a todo el mundo le habla, con todo el mundo se lleva bien, una persona que no es tímida, etc. Confident. Excuse me, continue, Cari.
Confident.
Uh-huh.
Alguien en quien confiar.
Alguien en quien confiar. Next.
Funny. Funny.
No sé funny.
Cómo se dice. Funny. Uh-huh.
Divertida.
Una persona divertida. Next.
Shy.
Uh-huh.
Tímido.
Una persona tímida. Excelente. Next.
Nervios.
Nervas. Con A.
Nervas.
Ajá.
Nerviosa.
Una persona nerviosa, vea, una persona que rápido todo se la pone mal de los nervios. Next.
Wild.
Excelente, wild. Uh-huh. Ajá. Wild, fine.
Salvaje.
Una persona salvaje, o sea, una persona pesada de comportamiento. Next.
Nauri.
Nauri, muy bien. Una persona, ahí lo está, una persona traviesa. Se puede referir a un niño, etcétera, etcétera. Next. Anxious.
Anxious.
Una persona ansiosa. Una persona ansiosa. Next.
Careless.
Una persona descuidada, que no se preocupa por si anda peinado, peinada, etcétera. Next.
Outspoken.
Outspoken. Una persona franca que le dice las cosas como son sin faltarle el respeto. Next.
Fearless.
Fearless. Una persona intrépida. Prácticamente una persona que no tiene. Que no tiene. Fear. Miedo. Fearless. Siguiente.
Brave.
Una persona valiente. Next.
Cheerful.
Una persona alegre. Next.
Upbeat.
Upbeat. Una persona optimista. Next.
Warm.
Una persona cálida. O sea, cae bien. No cálida de que esté tibio o helado o caliente. No. Una persona que... Qué bonito el modo de ella. Es bien cálido el modo. No sé si me doy a entender. Next.
Optimistic.
Ajá.
Optimista.
Una persona optimista. Lo pesimistic. Contrario. Pesimistic.
Pesimista.
Una persona pesimista. Next.
Energetic.
Una persona que toda la vida está con energías. Next. Y la última.
Lethargic.
Lethargic. Una persona letárgica. Ahora bien, sí le voy a pedir ayuda en esa palabra. Lethargic es una persona letárgica. ¿Qué significa una persona letárgica? No sé y le soy bien sincera. Letárgica. No sé si como que es de aprendizaje lento. No sé si viene por ahí la palabra. Ahí me ayuda. Ok, Génesis. Descríbete a ti misma. Aquí puedes comenzar. I consider myself. Yo me considero a mí misma. I consider myself. Y puedes usar el vocabulario que está ahí o el que tú quieras. Yes, Genesis. Thank you. Your audio, Genesis.
Perdón,
okay.
No le escuché nada de lo que me dijo.
Ok, puedes ocupar las palabras que están ahí o como tú quieras. Describe yourself. Y puedes comenzar. I describe myself. O sea, yo me considero a mí misma. Yes, please, go.
I describe myself, I'm shy, rare, complicated. I love being when I want, not very social, mm-hmm. and pessimistic mm-hmm. sometimes, okay. and confident.
And confident. Hey, confident, I consider, this is just a personal opinion, I consider confident is one of the most important personalities in my case, right? In my case. Thank you, Genesis. Please choose the next student. I'm going to help you. I have Jasmine and Daniela.
Daniela.
Okay, Daniela, please. Could you describe yourself? Thank you.
Okay, teacher. I consider myself as a serious, calm, a little angry, outspoken, upbeat, and a friendly person.
Okay, friendly person. Excellent. Thank you. Jasmine, in your opinion, can you please describe yourself?
I describe myself friendly, easygoing, mm-hmm. confident, mm-hmm. Maybe optimist.
Excellent. Perfect. Thank you. Let me see. Christian, can you please describe yourself?
Yes, teacher. I describe myself friendly, easygoing, funny, wild, fearless, brave, and energetic.
In your opinion, Christian, what's the most important personality for you?
Maybe brave.
Brave. Okay, yes. I agree with you. Thank you. Jeremy, thank can you. You please describe yourself?
How do you say egocentric?
Egocentric.
Oh.
Yeah.
I consider myself friendly, mm-hmm. egocentric, and funny.
And funny. So, yeah. What is the most important personality for you? Pero cuando se trata de otra persona, what is the most important?
I think friendly.
Friendly. Okay. In my case, yeah. can be easygoing. I like the people that are easygoing. Thank you, Jeremy. So, Jonathan, in your opinion, can you please describe yourself?
I consider myself is calm, mm-hmm. friendly, cheerful, mm-hmm. but also I she nervous and careless.
Okay, excellent. So, how old are you?
17 years.
No, pues no, no te puedo hacer esa pregunta porque estás todavía muy chiquito. Thank you. So, Marcela, Marcela, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you please, Marce, describe yourself?
Well, I consider myself friendly, emotional.
Ajá, muy bien.
Distracted. cheerful.
Mm-hmm.
Brave.
Mm-hmm.
And I think outspoken.
So, how old are you, Marce?
26 years old.
Okay, you're perfect. So, imagine mm-hmm. you are describing, esto es solo para practicar inglés. Imagine okay. you are describing the perfect boyfriend. What can be the three most important characteristics of talking about personality? Three. Number okay. one?
Intelligent.
Excellent. Obviously, intelligent. Number two?
Confident.
Perfect. Number three?
Cheerful.
And cheerful. Thank you so much. Let's see. I'm going to choose. Okay. Karina, please turn on your audio.
Okay.
How old are you, Karina?
I am 23 years old.
Perfect. Okay. So, Karina, imagine you are describing the perfect boyfriend.
Ay, my perfect boyfriend.
Three. Just three characteristics.
Confident.
Uh-huh.
Outspoken.
Uh-huh.
Intelligent.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. I'm going to choose a boy. ¿A quién fue que le quedó? Christian, please turn on your audio. Imagine you are describing your perfect girlfriend. What can be the three, the most important personality characteristic? Just three.
Funny, mm-hmm. funny, friendly, outspoken.
Outspoken, okay, thank you. Jeremy, in your opinion? Your audio is off. Thank you, Jeremy.
Ah, hola, hola, ¿qué pasó?
How old are you, Jeremy?
19 years old.
Okay, no, you're perfect. Imagine you are describing your perfect girlfriend. What can be the three characteristics? The most important.
I think easygoing, mm-hmm. Confident, mm-hmm. friendly, funny.
Okay.
And yeah, that's it.
Okay. Miren, bichos, me preocupan. Me preocupan o quizás no les interesa en el aspecto de que hay una característica que no me la dijo nadie. Y para mí es muy importante. ¿Cuál creen que es?
Beautiful.
bueno, yo no veo tan
careful, I think.
No. ¿Cómo?
Franco, pues sí,
no, hay una característica
rubia. Sincero.
Bueno,
no. Rubia. Sincero.
Rubia, dice el otro. Miren, se la voy a mandar en el chat. Excelente, no sé quién lo dijo. No, hombre, ya veo que la fidelidad no les importa a ustedes. Ya vi. Faithful. Nadie dijo faithful. ¿Qué significa faithful? Una persona
fiel.
Fiel. Pero ya vi que en este caso a ustedes les gustan los unfaithful, los infieles. Ok, vamos con la
no,
siguiente.
No, I don't like.
Ajá, nadie lo dijo, así que this is just my point of view. Ok. Ok, no, miren, yo solo lo hago por practicar inglés. La verdad que hay respeto ahí cada quien, ¿verdad? Ok, what do you do when you switch off? Hey, ¿se acuerdan qué significa switch off? Para los que no estuvieron en la clase, enséñenles por favor los que sí estuvieron. ¿Qué switch off?
Desconectarse.
Desconectarse del mundo, o sea, en este caso descansar, olvidar tareas, etcétera, trabajo, etcétera. Y hay tres formas de contestar. Bueno, hay más, pero yo quise poner solo tres. Podemos decir sometimes I like to. A veces a mí me gusta. Sometimes I like, lo que siempre decimos, sometimes I like to go to the beach, sometimes I like to go to the cinema. O sometimes I like to stay at home, etc. Otra forma puede ser, prepárense porque esa sí me la van a responder todos. Otra forma puede ser, well, teacher, I always like to stay at home and watch Netflix. I always like to go to the park and play with my friends. Or sometimes or always I like to go to the beach with my family and swing in the pool. Or in this case, I like to go to the cinema and watch the most famous movies there. Otra opinión puede ser, well, in my personal opinion, bla, 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 etcétera, etcétera, etcétera. Comienzo por el orden que me aparece acá. Esta es la última pregunta. Sí, antes de pasar a la siguiente dinámica. Voy en orden, Christian. What do you do when you switch off?
I always like to rest, watch movies, and listen to music.
Perfect. Daniela, what do you do when you switch off? ¿Se prepara Génesis?
I always like to read a book, or listen to music, or watch movies on Netflix, or series.
Perfect. Génesis, what do you do when you switch off? ¿Se prepara Jeremy Ventura?
Sometimes I like go out to take walk with my dog and anywhere outside and listen to music.
Perfect, muy bien. Jeremy, what do you do when you switch off? ¿Se prepara? No, I say Jeremy or Jonathan. Number one?
Jeremy, creo.
Okay, Jeremy, and then please, se prepara Jonathan. Okay, Jeremy, your opinion, please.
Always I like to play volleyball or basket with my friends or my family.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Yes, your opinion, Jonathan. Se prepara Karina.
Sometimes I like to. Sometimes I like to play piano or another instrument.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Karina. Your opinion. Se prepara Kayla.
Okay, sometimes I like look me up myself in my room, listen to music and paint.
Okay, thank you. Kayla, please, your opinion. Se prepara Marcela.
I always like to read a Bible and watch series in Netflix.
Okay, perfect, Marcela. Your opinion, please. Se prepara Marcelo.
When I'm with them, I prefer be with my friends or go to the beach. And...
Okay, perfect. Marcelo, please give us your opinion. Se prepara Camila Weiler.
Sometimes I like to play soccer and play video games as always.
Okay, nice, perfect, thank you. Okay, Miss Weiler, please give us your opinion. Se prepara Andrea Bracetti.
Sometimes I just
estos stop. Bichos tienen apellido de famoso, ya vieron, vea. Okay, sorry, continue.
Stop using my cell phone and watch series.
Okay, thank you, Andrea, please. And we are going to finish with Jasmine.
Sometimes I go to the beach. I like to walk alone and I forget everything. But also I like watch Netflix and listen to music.
Perfect.
And it's Italy.
Ah, your last name?
Yes.
From Italy.
Yes.
My last name is from San Salvador. Thank you. Okay. Jasmine, please, your opinion.
Hey, sorry. Sometimes okay. I like to listen to music, watch series on TV, and do exercise.
And do exercises.
Do exercise.
Okay, yes. Y otra palabra para decir que hacemos deporte es working out.
Okay.
Working out. Okay, señores. Este solamente es un pequeño ejercicio nada más. Quiero que, porque vamos a hacer una dinámica ahorita, que en lo personal esa dinámica a mí me encanta. Antes de ingresar a la siguiente dinámica, porque son tres, ya terminamos una, vamos con la segunda que es esta. Este solamente es un pequeño repaso. En la fotografía nosotros tenemos muchas cosas, televisiones, libros, hay personas, hay un perro, etcétera, etcétera. Aquí solamente es que usted me vaya diciendo si es true o si es false. Por ejemplo, número uno dice, there are 10 people in the room. Hay 10 personas en la habitación. ¿Es true o it is false?
False.
Ok, pero yo necesito, en este caso voy a escoger a dos personas que me ayuden a leer las oraciones. Una persona lee los números impares y otra persona me va leyendo los números pares. Volunteers, please.
Me, teacher.
Ok, I have Jasmine and Karina. Perdón, yo sé que todos me dijeron me porque sí se me activaron los, pero solo agarro los que me dicen nombres porque me dicen me y yo no sé quién es me. Ok, Karina, tú lees los números impares. Cristian, tú lees los números pares. Y todos les vamos a dar las respuestas. Ok, please.
There are 10 people in the room.
True or false?
False.
Why? ¿Por qué?
Because there are
six. Because there are six people. Ojo, vaya, voy con ese ejercicio. A ustedes les mandé un video que la maestra nos decía. Se dice una persona, one person. Pero cuando hay más de dos personas, ya no se dice one person. Se dice, por ejemplo, si son dos.
Two people,
three people, four people. Solo se utiliza person para singular. No se dice five person, no. Se dice one person, two people, three people, hasta los millones. Gracias ahí por el paréntesis, me acabo de acordar de eso. So there are six people.
People.
Number two.
They are in the kitchen.
Oh.
It's false. Why?
They are in the living room.
They are in the living room. Okay, next.
The TV is on.
True. Muy bien. Next.
The curtains are open.
It's true.
Next.
The sofa is red.
False.
Why?
The sofa is blue.
Okay.
Light blue.
Okay. Okay. Next.
Okay. There is a painting of flowers above the TV.
Is true or is false?
True.
Is true. True. Next.
There is a teddy on the chair.
True.
Next.
There is a key on the sofa beside Mr. Turner.
It's true.
Muy bien. Next.
The coffee table is circular.
Oh, it's rectangular.
It's false.
False.
Why?
Because it's rectangular.
Thank you. Next.
The rug is circular.
It's true.
Excellent. Next.
There are some building bricks on the roof.
True. Yes, it is true.
Obviously. Thank you. Next.
There is a plant on the windowsill.
It's true.
Excellent. Next.
There is a cat on the roof.
False.
Why?
There is a dog.
Because it is a dog. Next.
There is a football beside grandma.
It's false. Why?
How do you say beside in Spanish?
It's like a next to, como a la par.
Oh,
okay. Next to.
True.
Beside grandma.
False.
It's false because it's beside mom. Yes.
No.
Yes, it is. This is the football. Yes. And he's the mom, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it is true. Next.
There is a bookshelf beside the TV.
Besides or next to? It is true or false? It's bookshelf.
True.
Next.
There are two cushions on the sofa.
It's true.
Okay. Next.
There is a board game on the coffee table.
True.
It's true. Next.
The baby is crying.
It's true.
False.
It's false.
It's false. The baby.
Why?
It's happy.
The baby is happy or smiling. Está sonriendo. The baby is smiling. Next.
There is a dog in the garden.
False.
It's false. Next.
Grandma and dad are wearing glasses.
It's true. Yes, they are wearing glasses. Next.
Grandma is wearing boots.
False. Why?
She have a pantuflas.
How do you say pantuflas in English? Slippers. Excelente. Pantuflas. Next, and the last one.
That has got a mustache.
It's true.
Muy bien, señores. Este solamente era un pequeño ejercicio. Vamos con la última dinámica. Describe the pictures below. Para finalizar en este caso la última dinámica, les voy a enseñar, yo sé que a algunos no les va a costar. Aquí es cuestión de cuánto vocabulario usted maneja. Porque lo que vamos a hacer es que le voy a poner una serie de fotografías y usted me las va a tener que describir. ¿Cómo así, teacher? Me va a tener que describir qué hay en la foto. Hay dos opciones. Bueno, hay tres. Opción número uno, usted me puede describir la fotografía simplemente mencionándome los objetos que hay. Opción número dos, usted me puede describir la fotografía simple y sencillamente diciéndome qué acciones están haciendo las personas. Por ejemplo, si ve personas jugando, playing, si ve personas cocinando, cooking, si ve personas corriendo, running, etc. O puede, opción número tres, mencionarme vocabulario y también acciones, que de hecho me encantaría más que hicieran eso. Teacher, ¿y cómo quiere que haga eso si usted no me ha enseñado? Ahorita yo le enseño. Observe en este caso la fotografía. Hay mucho vocabulario ahí. Vámonos al chat de Zoom. Le doy 5 segundos para que se ubique. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Escríbame solamente objetos en inglés que usted vea en esa fotografía. Por ejemplo, there is a yellow lamp. Hay una lámpara amarilla. Vamos, escríbame por favor los objetos. Okay, cuando si queremos decir un sofá rosado, there is a pink sofa. Primero va el color. There is a pink sofa. Floor, toys, newspaper, teddy bear, yellow lamp, muy bien, rug, there is a window, there is a pink sofa, blocks, 2 pillows. Ok, en este caso son cojines. Pillows son almohadas. Cojines son cushions. ¿Se acuerdan cuando vimos esa palabra, verdad? Cushions. No escuche, no. Cushions. Cojines. Muy bien. Observe la segunda fotografía. Mencióneme los objetos que hay en la segunda fotografía. TV, plant, sofa, plant, curtain, flower. Table, window. Pregunta, ¿por qué nadie me ha puesto aspiradora? ¿Cómo se dice aspiradora, señores? Perdón, Marcelo, no lo vi, hijo, no lo vi. Perdón, Marcelito, no lo vi. Igual, se los mando ahí. Vacuum cleaner. Aspiradora, muy bien, excelente. Books. Heater, muy bien. Que es como un calentador. Eso más que todo en Estados Unidos. Acá no, nosotros no necesitamos. Ok. Quiero que observe acá la siguiente. Describing the picture. Opción uno, usted me puede decir, porque hoy no se va a salir de la clase hasta que no me describa las fotografías. Opción uno, podemos decir, in the picture there is a. Si vamos a mencionar un objeto, dicho yo eso ya lo sé, sí, pero hay gente que no. Entonces, in the picture there is a table. Pero si hay un ejemplo, si hay 4 sillas, no digo there is, digo there are. Eso ya lo vimos también. In the picture there are 4 chairs, por ejemplo. Otra cosa, otro ejemplo que podemos usar, I see. Yo veo personas y ahí dice ing. Si usted ve personas cantando, I see people singing. Si yo veo personas limpiando, I see people cleaning. Si yo veo personas bailando, I see people dancing. Otro ejemplo puede ser, in my opinion, the picture is about. Esta me encanta. En mi opinión, la fotografía trata de o es acerca de. Teacher, in my opinion, the picture is about a family. Trata acerca de una familia. Y usted comienza. There is acá, there are, there is, I see people, bla, 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 etc. I see people, They are singing, cooking, etc. Ahora bien, tips. Y con eso termino para que comience usted. Use an introduction. ¿Cómo así, teacher? Cuando usted me vaya a describir la fotografía, dígame. Hello, good evening, teacher. My name is Chepito. I'm going to describe the picture. Hello, students. My name is Chepito. I'm going to describe the picture. I'm going to describe the picture. I'm going to talk about the picture, etc. Otro tips puede ser. Teacher, yo todavía no tengo ese nivel. Bueno, vaya a ser lo más básico. Mention the vocabulary you know. Menciona el vocabulario que usted ya se sabe. Puede mencionar places, colors, food, etc. Describe the picture using the action verbs. Me encantaría que usaran el punto número 3. Lo que le acabo de decir. Si ve gente jugando, si ve gente cocinando, si ve gente corriendo, etc. Ok. Y aquí le tengo otro ejemplo más. Si yo fuera a describir esta fotografía, observe. Let me see. Jasmine, ¿me ayuda por favor a leer? Thank you.
Hello. Sorry, yes. Teacher.
Yes, perfect. Can you please help me to read?
Okay, okay. This is a family picture. There are 6 people in the picture.
Perdón, ahí, three women.
Sí, 3 women and 3 men.
Stop. Ahora bien, thank you. Yo digo 3 women, otro error que me cometen los alumnos. Para decir que hay 3 mujeres, 3 women, me dicen, no. Women. Woman es singular, ¿verdad? Y women es plural. Lo mismo con hombres y hombres. Man es singular y men es plural. Si yo digo, hay un hombre, there is one man. Hay 3 hombres, there are 3 men. Continue, Yasmin.
Okay, grandpa is wearing a blue and red shirt. A pair of gray pants and a pair of
red.
Red, ¿verdad? Mm-hmm. Red, yellow shoes. Grandma is wearing a red dress, mm-hmm. blue shoes, and a green purse. Dad is wearing a green and red sweater.
Mm-hmm. Sweater.
Mm-hmm. And a pair of shoes.
En a pair of shoes. Perdón, ahí no sé por qué se me hizo pequeña la imagen. Perdón, grande, porque se esconden algunas palabras. Ok, ahora bien. En ese caso yo me fui por la ropa. Wearing, usando o vistiendo. Grandma, se refiere a la abuela. Grandma is wearing a red dress, blue shoes, zapatos azules, and green purse. ¿Qué es purse? Bolso. Ahora bien, este puede ser otro ejemplo de cómo usted puede describir fotografías. Ok, voy con la siguiente y aquí termino el ejercicio. Tengo otra foto, podemos mencionar los objetos, podemos mencionar lo que hay, etcétera. Pero si usted se fija, por ejemplo, dice, the boy number one is painting. Estoy ocupando presente continuous. ¿Qué está haciendo el chico?
Pintando.
Pintando.
Pintando. ¿Y qué está pintando? An animal. Después puse, he's wearing. ¿Qué está vistiendo? A blue shirt. Yo la vi blue, pero ahorita la estoy viendo morada. A blue shirt and apron. Ahí es con N al final. Apron. And a pair of green pants. Yo sé que todo el vocabulario que acabo de leer, usted lo maneja, menos esta palabra. Apron. ¿Qué significa apron?
Delantal.
Delantal. Excelente. Entonces, the boy number one is wearing... He's painting an animal. He's wearing a blue shirt, an apron, and a pair of green pants. Ojo, el color va antes. No se dice en a pair pants green. Yo sé que en español sí decimos pantalones verdes, pero en inglés cambia la posición de las palabras. Ok, vamos con la primera fotografía. Le doy 10 segundos para que se prepare y voy comenzando con... Ya le digo con quién en lo que se prepara. Comienzo con Daniela. Ok, preparémonos. 10 segundos. Empiezo con Dani. 9, 8, 7, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Okay, Dani, please, your opinion, y se prepara Marcelo. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Dani. I'm going to describe the picture. It's about many children. They are studying. I think that they are at school. They are writing. There are two girls, mm-hmm, and five boys. Mm-hmm. The boy number one, mm-hmm, is wearing a yellow and blue sweater. Mm-hmm. The boy number two is wearing a shirt.
Okay, stop. Thank you, Dani. Okay, Marcelo, please. And se prepara Jonathan Ventura. Okay, Marcelo, please give us your opinion.
Hello, my name is Marcelo. I'm going to describe the picture, and my opinion,
the picture is about?
The picture is about a study. One o'clock, the arms, the keep, the table, eraser, cheer, mm-hmm, hair, mm-hmm, a smile.
Yes. How many girls?
¿Cómo se dice regla?
How many girls? One, two, three girls. And how many boys?
Two girls.
Okay. Two girls.
And five.
Boys.
No, boys.
Okay. Thank you so much. Please. Next, y se prepara Jasmine. Mr. Ventura.
Teacher, yo tengo una duda.
Ok, permíteme que alguien tiene. Yes, dime, Kayla.
¿Cómo se dice camisa con cuadros?
In this case, we can say square shirt. Okay, porque square es de cuadros. Yes. Ok, Mr. Ventura, ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Ok, please, go. And please be ready, Jasmine. Ok, thank you, go. Please, Jonathan.
Hello, my name is Jonathan, and I'm going to describe the picture. I see that they are a class with a lot of students. The boy that he is sweeter blue. And I think that his work, teamwork, mm-hmm, with the boy next to.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
If you want, you can mention the objects.
I see. What?
I see books. I see a map, posters.
Notebooks, pens, mm-hmm, and
mm-hmm. Yes.
I think that the behind.
Uh-huh, yes.
Is a. I don't see.
Behind them there are some posters, plants, figures.
Yeah.
There is a radio.
I think.
Okay, okay, thank you, Jonathan. That's it, thank you. Okay, Jasmine, contigo termino esta foto. Thank you. Yes.
Okay. Go. Okay, good evening. My name is Jasmine. I'm going to describe the pictures. They are a student working on your workbook. Mm-hmm. In your classroom have plants, pictures about animals, and mm-hmm. workers.
Yes. Nice. Perfect. Simple. Okay. 10 segundos. Vamos con la siguiente fotografía. Y voy a iniciar con Karina. Okay, Karina, please be ready. En 10 segundos.
Teacher, I'm ready.
Okay, wait a minute, please. Thank you, princess. And then, y sigue Camila. Okay, Karina, you're ready. Excellent, please. Se prepara.
Okay.
Se prepara, perdón. Se prepara Camila. Okay, Cari, go.
Hello, my name is Karina. And I'm going to describe the picture. It's it's a picnic picture. I see the grapes, hat. I see the champagne. I see the mountains, and I see the clouds. How do you say nube?
Yes, clouds. Some clouds.
Mm-hmm. Some clouds. And
tomatoes. Bread.
Tomato. Uh-huh, bread. A basket. Are two cups.
Cups.
Are two mm-hmm. cups.
Old wine.
And flowers.
And flowers. Okay, thank you. En este caso, cups. Two cups. Okay, thank you. Yes, please. Camila, y se prepara Andrea. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Camila. I'm going to describe the picture. I see food. I see hat. There is bread. There are tomatoes.
In this case, 1, 2, 3 tomatoes.
Three tomatoes.
Tenemos manzanas, uvas, fresas.
No sé.
Beans. Manzanas, apples.
Apples.
Uvas.
Uvas, no sé cómo se dice.
Grapes. Fresas. Strawberries. Y una canasta. And a basket. Okay, thank you. Next, Andrea.
Yes.
Go.
I am going to talk about this picture. There are green grapes. There are three tomatoes. There are two glasses of wine.
Mm-hmm. Wine.
Wine. I can see trees or mountain.
Three mountains. Okay. Okay. Thank you. That's it. Muy bien. Next. 10 segundos. Se prepara Christian. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, please, Christian, give us your opinion. And let me see Marcela. Y se prepara Marcela. Okay, thank you, Christian.
Hello, teacher. My name is Chepito. No, sorry, Christian.
Okay.
I'm going to describe the picture. I see a family with a dad, a mom, and two kids. I see a cake, two muffins, hats.
How do you say sombrero de cumpleaños? Fácil.
Party hats?
Birthday
hats.
Yeah. Okay.
And behind of the family, I see knives and a window.
How do you say candelas?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Candles. 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 ¿Y cómo sería candelitas de cumpleaños o candelas de cumpleaños?
Birthday candles.
Excelente. Ok, next. Who's next? Marcela. Y se prepara Jeremy Ventura. Ok, Marce.
Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Marcela. And I see a family celebrating a birthday. The family is there is a two children, mom mm-hmm. and dad.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the family who in the no, sorry, eating the cake.
Uh-huh.
And
how do you say tomando una selfie?
Take a selfie.
Taking a selfie. Okay, Marce. Okay, okay. Uh-huh. Please continue.
And there is a candy.
Mm-hmm.
At four muffins.
Mm-hmm.
There.
We can say muffins or cupcakes.
Cupcake, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Yes, that's it. Thank you, Marce. Okay, Mr. Ventura, ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, Jeremy, go.
Okay, hi guys. My name is Jeremy Ventura, and I'm going to describe the pictures. It's about a family enjoying son's birthday, and I can see very beautiful family, and they are very happy.
Okay, maybe yes. It's a birthday party, right?
Birthday party.
Yes, excellent. Ah, okay. Thank you, Mr. Ventura. Okay. Okay. Comienzo con Keila para la siguiente fotografía. Solamente que por el tiempo, si van a describir a algunas de las personas, escojan solamente dos por el tiempo. Comienzo con Keila y se prepara. Vamos a ver a quién escojo. Y, ok, voluntario. ¿Alguien que quiera describir después de Keila? Vamos a hacer un voluntario. 5, 4, 3, 2, no one, really? Okay, okay, Christian, thank you. Entonces, comienzo con Keila, se prepara Christian. Okay, Keila, please, go.
Okay, good evening, everyone. I describe this picture. I see one boy. She have a green shirt and blue pants and black shoes. And I see one girl. She have a yellow shirt and gray pants and black shoes. Your hair is corto, no sé cómo se dice.
Short.
Your hair is okay. Your hair is short and
en este caso, ¿cómo brown. Es caballero o es niña?
La niña de amarillo.
Sería hair. Su cabello, okay. El cabello de ella.
Okay. Her hair is short. Okay, her hair is short and short. Round.
Excelente. Next, Christian, se prepara Marcelo.
Hi, again. My name is Christian. I see five people. A man wearing a green shirt, black pants, black shoes, his short hair.
He has short hair.
Uh-huh. And his hair is black.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Marcelo. Please.
Cualquiera de las dos.
Sí, puedes escoger dos personas, solo dos.
Read shirt.
Te escucho tan concentrado al fondo, Marcelo. La Celeste está jugando. Ok, Marcelo, go.
Sí.
Ok, go.
The red shirt and blue shirt and orange shirt and yellow shirt and more or no?
One more, please.
Shorts or pants blue.
Okay, blue pants. Uh-huh. Okay, perfect, thank you. Okay, next. Vamos a ver, quiero ver esta. Si se quiere salir de la clase, descríbame esa fotografía. Volunteers.
Marcela. Yo, Jeremy.
Marcela one, Jeremy number yes. two, Marcelo number three. Hasta ahí me quedo porque ahí uh-huh. se me olvida. Marcela number one. Jeremy number two, Marcelo number three. Okay, Marce, go.
I'm going to start the picture. I see five children. Two children playing football. And the girl wearing a pink shirt. I think it's a yellow shirt.
Okay, yeah, and, finish. Yes, okay. Thank you, Marcelita. Thank you, see you on Friday. Okay, Jeremy, yeah. Go.
Okay, hi, I'm going to describe the pictures. I can see a beautiful place, and there are two people playing volleyball or soccer.
Yeah.
I don't know. And I see three people playing on the sun. Mm-hmm. Okay. And yeah, that's it.
That's it. Okay, perfect. Thank you. Please, Marcelo, go.
The picture is about the sand. No. Sorry. Children play and sand and toy and one more or no?
One more. Yes, please. Thank you. One more.
the easy blue sheet.
Okay, thank you, Marcelo. Hey, nadie me dijo construyendo un castillo. La niña está construyendo un castillo. ¿Cómo se dirá eso?
Building
a castle.
Building a castle.
Okay, volunteer. Castle.
Just me, Kristen.
Jasmine one. Danny. Kristen number two y Danny number three. Okay, hasta ahí me quedo. Chris, Jasmine one, Christian number two, and Danny number three. Okay, Jasmine, go.
Okay, I'm going to describe the pictures. They are the kids playing on their free time thing at school. They are two girls and three boys.
Excellent. Yes, simple. Muy bien. Thank you, Jasmine. Next, Christian.
Hi, I'm going to describe the picture. I see five kids. The kid in the middle, he's playing with a truck toy. Yeah. The
so girl with a truck.
With a truck, okay. The girl in the right, she's playing with
on.
She's building a castle. Mm-hmm. A sandcastle.
Yes.
And the kids behind the picture, They are playing with a ball.
Excelente. Thank you, Christian.
Thank you.
Gabby. See you.
Okay.
Okay.
I see three boys and two girls. A boy and a girl are playing volleyball. Two boys and a girl are playing on the sand. Two of them are building sand castles. And one is playing with a truck.
With a truck. Okay, thank you. Yes, that's it. Thank you, Dani. Good night. Three volunteers. Nombres.
Teacher Keila.
Keila, Karina. Camila, and Karina. Okay, Keila one, Camila number two, Camila number two, and Karina number three. Okay, Keila, go.
Okay, I see in the picture five kids, two are girls. One, the first girl here is yellow. Your shirt are red and your pants are sky blue.
Okay, the en este caso, perdón, hija, si vamos a hablar de un chico, por ejemplo, sus pantalones son azules. His pants, y si son los pantalones de ella, her pants, porque si decís your, okay. Si decís your, estás como que me estás describiendo a mí, tú. Entonces aquí, his para niño, her para niña, ¿ok?
Okay, the second girl, her pants is yellow, her shirt is pink, and her hair are brown.
Excellent. Thank you. Good night, princess.
Thank you, teacher.
Next, Cami.
Oh, sí.
Yes.
I see five children. Three boys and two girls. I see a ball. A girl has brown hair, pink shirt, and yellow skirt.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Cami. Good night.
Good night.
Okay, Karina, go.
Okay. The description of the picture is about the five kids probably play on the beach. Are two girls and three boys, and two people are playing with ball, and the other three play in the sun.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Good night, princess. Bye. Volunteers. Nombres.
Yo,
Andrea. Andrea, one.
Jonathan.
Jonathan, number two. Okay. Go.
Okay. The picture is about five sugars and three children are playing with the sound, and two children playing is baseball or football.
Yes, okay.
I don't know. Only that.
Okay, thank you, Andrea. Good night. Good night. Okay. Yes, next.
Okay. I see in the picture three boys and two girls, and the girl of the yellow hair is building a sandcastle. The boy of ¿cómo se dice cabello claro? Bueno, los dos tienen, los tres tienen cabello claro, así que the boys
light, en este caso shirt. ¿Cómo es café claro? ¿Podemos decir sí o no? ¿O te referís a la rubia?
No, no, el niño este
de celeste.
Que está a la izquierda, sí, sí.
Ok, light brown hair, como café claro o castaño, light brown.
Oh, okay. The boy with light brown hair. he is playing with his toys.
Uh-huh.
And the children the playing with your hands. That's it.
Okay, okay. Okay, miren, ustedes como están más pendientes del partido ahora, los agarré en curva. No, hombre, gracias señores, nos vemos el día viernes a las 7 de la noche. Cuídense, buenas noches.
Okay, bueno.